present the award to Srimati Kumudini Lakhia. The award comprises a shawl, memento, a scroll, and a check. After the shawl and memento, the scroll. And the check. May I now request Sri Lalit Man Singh to kindly address the gathering.
This evening, we are honoring two legends. One who left us about 2 years ago, but who has been a great presence on the cultural life of this country and particularly of this city. I'm talking of Mrs. Sumitra Chandra. She was truly the Tsarina of the performing arts of this city. And I can almost feel her presence here. That is her seat. She used to be there, and she was a center of attention. It is a great loss to this city and to the country that she left us so early. So I'm very happy that Shobha is carrying on her legacy, and the entire family is giving its support. There is Siddharth, there's Gauri, Deepak, everybody carrying on the legacy of Mrs. Chandra. But today we are honoring a living legend, and that is Kumudini Lakhia. Just as people have remembered Sachin Tendulkar in the last couple of days, I think people need to remember the great jewels that we have in other fields like the performing arts. I must start with a disclosure that I have always been an ardent admirer of Kumudini Lakhia, and I always will be, so do not expect any objectivity from me. I heard about Kumudini Lakhia in the 60s, but I actually saw her on stage in the 70s, and I worked closely with her in the 80s. In the 70s, I remember one of the great jobs I performed was to act as a chauffeur once after a program of hers at Sapru House. The program was over and there was no conveyance. So I said, I have a car, I can place it at your disposal. So I had to drive her and her students to wherever they had to go. I'm proud that I have been able to perform that duty. And I say I'm an admirer because as I have followed her life, it is quite remarkable. Whether as a dancer, as a guru, as a choreographer, she had what is called a touch of gold. Whatever she did was of the highest level of excellence. There was no second quality in her life. And she made it appear as if it was effortless, but later on I learned how much of hard work went into making it look effortless and flawless. Now, look at her life itself. She trained in both the Jaipur Gharana and the Lucknow Gharana. She has been trained by great people like Pandit Shammu Maharaj. She has been a partner in dance to Pandit Birju Maharaj. She has been a partner with the legendary Ram Gopal in all his performances abroad in Europe. And what an experience that must have been. Incidentally, Ram Gopal I came to know a little bit in London, alas, in his last years of life. And one particular thing, as a digression, I can tell you. He called me one day and said, "Hi, Commissioner, you must issue me a new passport because I have lost my passport." So I said, did you have a British passport or an Indian passport? He said, that's what I can't remember. Kumi Ben, as we called her, first time I'm knowing that she's called also called KG. But Kumudini was like, what shall I say, like a live wire, an electric live wire on stage. And I came to discover later on, she was equally a live wire off the stage. But more on that later. What I like about her is that she gave a new meaning to choreography. Earlier, what one saw as choreography was synchronized dance. You have a group of people who are taught to do the same movement together. It's somewhat like a military drill. And in many, many dance styles, that is what passes off as choreography. All choreography meant that you string together a lot of episodes and make a ballet out of it. But what she did, and as a layman, I'm admiring what she did. She turned this into a creative art by itself. That she used rhythms, she used body movements, she used geometrical patterns to create the kind of creativity that we had not seen in dance before. And that too within the four walls of classical dance. I think that will always remain as her greatest contribution to dance. So when I look back, it is a lifetime, really a full lifetime of achievement. Now, I mentioned to you that I had an opportunity to work closely with her in the 80s. That is when I was in ICCR. And I remember that we had the biggest, the mother of all festivals, was the Festival of India in the Soviet Union. We haven't done a festival of that scale ever since. But for the closing of the festival, we required two very special creative artists. One was to be a musician, the other was to be a dancer, because the theme of the closing ceremony, which was in the Kremlin, was to be confluence of culture. So two eminent artists were selected. One was Pandit Ravi Shankar, the other was Kumudini Lakhia. And both produced outstanding works of art. Ravi Shankar ji brought traditional Russian music and Indian classical music together in an effortless way. And the same thing was done by Kumudini Lakhia with regard to dance. It was wonderful to see this this performance of what was billed as Kathak. But actually it was the story of Kathak that she has choreographed. And in came the early stages of Kathak. And then came the foreign influence of Kathak. And this is where she very subtly brought in the dancers from Uzbekistan with their traditional dresses. They did Uzbek dance. And then gradually you saw how Uzbek dance influenced Kathak dancing. And there was the very memorable last scene, which was like a tarana, where the Uzbek dancers and the Kathak dancers danced together. And at the end of it, you couldn't make out who was an Uzbek dancer and who was a Kathak dancer. I think it was a brilliant piece of choreography, and only Kumudini Lakhia could have done that. So off the stage, of course, I promised to tell you, the only thing I can say is, off the stage, she is as entertaining as she is on stage. She has a very irreverent sense of humor. And she generally has a very irreverent style. So no matter what was the status or the position or the eminence of the person who she was meeting, she took that person on her own terms and was never ever intimidated by everyone. So I admire her free spirit and her courage in facing situations without any inhibition whatsoever. Let me say that if there was one person who deserved a lifetime award named after Mrs. Charles Ram, I think it is Kumudini Lakhia. So I'm very pleased that this award has gone this year to the one and only Kumudini Lakhia.
May I now request Srimati Kumudini Lakhia to kindly speak a few words.
All my friends from the Charitram family, all my family here in Delhi, this is not just an honor for me, it's a blessing from Sumitraji, which comes from a person I loved and I respected a great deal. I'll tell you something about Sumitraji. I got the scholarship for Kathak from the HRD ministry in 1957, and I came to Delhi not knowing anyone in Delhi, hoping that I'll find a place to stay. And I looked everywhere and I couldn't find a place to stay. Finally, I got one room in a house in Connaught Place, and I started my training at the Bharti Kala Kendra in Pusa Road. After a few days, I realized that the place I was staying at was not a place where I could stay for too long. I won't tell you why. So I went to Sumitraji the next morning at the Kendra and I said that I'm afraid, I think I'll have to give up the scholarship. She says, why? I said, because I cannot find a place to stay. Where are you staying now? I said, I'm staying in a place in Connaught Place. So she said, okay, let me see. After the class was over, she said to me, come with me and enter my car. Come sit in my car. And then she took me to the place where I was staying. She came inside with me. She said, pack your bag. Have you paid? I said, I paid for the whole month. Forget the payment. Just pack your bag. Tell her you're leaving and come with me. And she took me home. She didn't know me at all then. She didn't know where I came from, who I was. She took me home. And she said, you stay here until you find a place. Okay, I started staying with them. Whenever I found a place, Deepak, Shobha, Chiku, Gauri would stand in a line and say, why are you leaving us? And they would say to Sumitraji, why are you asking her to go? Please stay, please. And then I stayed for 3 years in that family. All throughout. That was the love I got from this family and from Sumitraji. Also, Charitramji said, your name is too long. I cannot call you Kumudiniji. So I'm going to call you KG. And that's how I became KG for this family. The servants, of course, added one more G, so I came KGG. Anyway, that's how I stayed in Delhi and I started my training with Shambhu Maharaj. After I'd been there for some time, few days I think, Begum Zaidi was wanting to make a production of Shakuntala. And Sumitraji called me to the office and she said, Begum Zaidi wants you to play the part of Shakuntala. And I have said yes. So from tomorrow you go to the rehearsals for her play, dance ballet. So I went on Sumitraji's instruction. I went there for 2 days and Shambhu Maharaji took objection. He said, aap Kathak sikhne aaye ya Shakuntala karne aaye? So he told Sumitraji, I'm not going to allow any of my students to take part in any of the other dance ballets taking place in Delhi. So the Kathak training started. It was wonderful with Shambhu Maharaji. Of course, he was a little rough and sometimes I didn't understand his language. There were a lot of words which I'd never heard before. I know them all now, but I don't use them. And then came the Ram Leela. And Sumitraji wanted me to play the part of Sita.